And you're going to take your block, and you might want to cover the block with your blanket. That's why I gave you blankets for extra padding. So the block's going to go underneath your right knee. And so your pelvis is going to be twisted a little bit, asymmetrical. Yeah, just if you feel like if the foam feels too firm, the blanket will just give you extra padding because we're going to be just pushing the knee down. All right, so you're in your all fours, but now you're just kind of in an asymmetrical position. Your right pelvis is rotated backwards, and your left pelvis is rotated forwards. Okay, so toes are on the floor, hands are on the floor. We're going to do some work with the right hip. So you're going to push that right knee down, and you're going to lift the whole left leg up off the floor, the knees, the toes, the shin. And then with control, you will slowly lower back down. And then you'll lift. So now you're rotating the left side of the pelvis back. And then as you lower, the left side of the pelvis is rotating forwards. And you're going to keep doing this, lifting and lowering. And so this is work that's happening in the lateral hip muscles on the right now. Good, keep going. Nice. Okay. The next time you have the leg lifted, keep it lifted. So see if you can sense where you are in space. See if you can sense whether your left hip is elevated above your right hip or if it's even. See if you can get it even so that if you look through towards your legs, your knees would basically be level with each other. Press your hands into the floor. Notice all the work that your shoulders are doing because other parts of your body have to take over when you don't have that other piece of your foundation. And then slowly lower down. And come off the block. Both knees are on the floor. Take a Rast Child's Pose. You can come on your belly or sit.